ASH, the American Society of Hematology, has always been at the cutting edge of innovation in our field. And one of those innovations has been the incorporation of not only online materials, but social media. That is, in fact, Twitter. And what they've done is, over the last few years, started to perfect a series of sessions playing on the tune of How I Treat, which is the review series in Blood, and changing it to How I Tweet with me this year. ASH, together with the investigators, launched a brand new initiative. It was called Ashapalooza. It was a festival-like atmosphere at Petco Field, right across the street from here, the convention center. And in a baseball, sports, festival-style scenario, allowed us as the teachers to be able to interact with the fellows in a unique, unprecedented way. My session, How I Tweet, was great. We did it as a 5-minute TED Talk style, called Ignite style of PowerPoint slides, 15 seconds a slide, 20 slides only, high yield pearls. And I was able to have a portable microphone on, walk around, and basically I wanted to tell the trainees 3 or 4 points about social media. One is that social media is critical and important in order to ascertain, that means get information about what's going on in the field from now on. 5 minutes in the morning when you're in the coffee line, few minutes in the evening, you can know what's going on in the world. Blood, New England Journal, JCO, VJ Hemonc, New York Times, whoever you want to follow. Thought leaders in the field, Ruben Mesa. The second point is that it's for personal branding. People don't talk about that a lot, but each physician, researcher, lab group has their own identity. What does your research stand for? And when we write review articles and original articles, those usually generally reach the other people in our field who are doing a research paper of their own. But we are missing a wide variety of healthcare stakeholders, the general public, loved ones, caregivers, patients with that disease. And now, with the democratization of information made possible by this digital era, I feel strongly that everybody should have cutting-edge information and thoughts and discussions at their fingertips. So I think it's essential for young faculty to establish themselves quickly and get a personal brand. The third facet of this is it's a great way to connect and collaborate with thought leaders in your field. I myself benefited this when I was a junior faculty. I was able to meet key opinion leaders much earlier than I would have in real life, or IRL as the kids call it these days, at these meetings. And then, can you believe it, amazingly, that then led to in-person collaborations. When we see each other at meetings, there's a closeness, there's a way to promote each other's research. And then I have actually published research papers on this exact topic, which is hematology in social media. So by using it as news aggregation, using it as a way to establish your own research by tweeting out links to your own papers and papers in your field, and then using it as a way to connect with thought leaders and people in your field, social media has become a way to leverage your own career development and to get usable, accurate information to the general public, the people who need it the most, patients and loved ones, especially in the very rare blood cancers which I deal in.